Once again, I find myself travelling on a train. Nothing too unusual about that for me, except this time, my destination is a little unusual. This is Berney Arms, one of England's remotest train stations. It's a tiny station halt on the branch line between Norwich and Great Yarmouth, and really is in the middle of nowhere. The station, built in 1844, is named after Thomas Berney. He's the man that the railway company had to buy the land off of to run the railway line across the marshes. He said that was fine as long as they put a station along the way. Marshes don't attract that many passengers on its two trains a day in each direction service, but on a Sunday that's doubled as quite a lot of local ramblers and walkers come to this area, in particular to check out this local landmark, the windmill. Built in the 1870s, this 21 metre tall windmill is a National Heritage Monument. So you've got the windmill, the marshes, the train station, what else is there here? That's right, there's a pub.
Slight bit of madness, I'd say. From a nice house with central heating to an old pub built in the 1700s with more gaps than heating.
This is Tracy. Her and her husband became the landlords in 2009 and had to adjust from their bustling native Birmingham to the quiet backwaters of Norfolk.
Well, to come from a city to the middle of nowhere, where the only amenity you've got is electric. You've got no road, no sewerage, no gas, water from a well, no rubbish collection, and you have to go 3 miles for the post and beat the wildlife to it.
So if it's that remote, then who does come to the pub?
It all varies because we're very tide restricted. So if the boats can get to us because of the bridges that I have to get under, they'll get to us, or they wait here, waiting for the bridges. Walkers, it depends on the weather, because you don't really want a 5 mile walk if it's soaking.
You also don't want a 5 mile walk back by just missing the last train, so make sure you check the timetable.